Well, so here it is, the ML1 modern Lefty version, and this, I believe it's called Blue Sky, the color. Very, very nice color, actually. So if we start from the top, we have a reversed headstock with Chapman branded tuners, 18:1 ratio. And actually, these are really good tuners. I had no problems at all with it. So, working fine. We have normal string trees. And, oh, here is my dog too. they are, I mean, normal string trees. If the guitar was equipped with a tremolo, I would probably change them to some roller string trees instead, but in this case it works really good, and the guitar is very easy to tune, and I had no issues at all with it. So nut is a Graftec nut, self-lubricating, and like I told you, it's tuning stability is really perfect, at least on my guitar, so no complaints there. And then we have a really nice ebony fretboard with this infinity inlay at the 12th fret, and it's really a smooth and nice fretboard. When I received the guitar, I restrung it, changed the strings, and I did nothing else. And I mean, the frets are really nicely done, and also in the end of each fret they are nicely rounded, and nothing is sticking out or nothing. Everything is perfect with this guitar, so really nice. If we move to the pickups are also, now I have some reflections from my, okay, here we go. Pickups are also Chapman branded pickups. They are ceramic pickups, medium to hot output, around, I think the bridge pickup is around 12k output, and the neck pickup is around 10k, something like that. And so it's, yeah, quite hot pickups, but not super hot. And then we have a hip shot style bridge, also rounded at the edges, and it's very comfortable to rest your hand. Really, really comfortable to play. And then we have master volume, three-way switch, tone control, and if you lift the top of the tone control, you can actually coil split the humbuckers, so you will have more like a single coil sound. The body is carved here for better access to the upper frets. Top is the body is made of mahogany, and top is a thin layer of veneer, which they then stained. Really, really nice top. And then on the side, they just masked off the body and made a natural binding. So what you see here is actually the body. Really nice touch, in my opinion. The joints here for the neck is really tight. There are no gaps. I mean, everything about this guitar, if you consider the price, is really nicely done. There is nothing no scratches. Now there are some scratches because I played it quite a lot, but when I received the guitar there were really nothing, no scratches, buffed very nice, and nothing to complain about actually. So if we flip the guitar, neck is it's a maple neck, quite thin, maybe not like a Ibanez wizard neck, but in my opinion it's a similar feel anyway. So, and it's satin, so it's really smooth, very easy to move your hand up and down the fretboard, and really comfortable to play, really. And this is the tuners, Chapman branded, work fine, I had no issues at all. This is really a nice touch in my opinion. It's instead of this big block like you have on the Fender style guitar, they rounded it, and it's much easier to reach the upper frets. So it's a really nice touch, and it's a bolt-on. We have let's see, string through body, also very nicely done. There is no imperfections or nothing, really, really nice done. And if we take a look at the electronics, we had the tone pot here, and like I told you, it's you can do, it's also a switch, so you can coil split the pickups. And then we have a three-way switch, and actually it's quite nice, this switch. It's not this regular circuit board switch, it's actually a proper switch, and it seems to hold high quality. The only thing I can complain about the switch is that when you change positions, it's a little bit stiff. So I would prefer it if it was a little bit easier to change the positions, but I don't know, in time maybe it will wear in, and maybe it will be a little bit easier. And you can see the volume put, and these are full size puts. So, and seems to be, I mean, if you consider the price of the guitar, I mean, absolutely good quality. The wiring is nice, soldering is nice. They took the time to shield the whole cavity with conductive paint, and also they shielded the cover here too. And I mean, the guitar is very quiet when you plug it in, even with some gain. It's not noisy at all. So I mean, really nicely done. So and I will tell you the story about this guitar, because I live in Sweden and we have a retailer. It's about 60 kilometers from where I live in a town called Malmö. And they ordered five of these guitars, Lefty guitars. And I saw it on their website, and I was, you know, thinking about buying one, and I couldn't decide. And then I called, maybe after 1 week, I think, after I saw they had five in stock. And they told me that, yeah, we had five, but we sold four, so we only have one left. And they sold directly. It's like people have high interest in these guitars. Okay, so I went to the store and played it a little bit, and I instantly fall in love with the guitar, and I decided to buy it, and really I have no regrets about this guitar.
And the pickups, first I was thinking about, yeah, but I can always change the pickups, and because maybe they are not so good and maybe they are not to my liking. But really, after playing with this guitar for a month or so now, I really like these pickups. It's they have a different feel, different sound. They are ceramic, so you get this ceramic type of sound. But there is something with these pickups when you reach the 12th fret, and then when you start play after the 12th fret, you hit some kind of sweet spot. Even if you have some gain, they really start to come alive, and you get this really smooth lead sound, and I like it so much. So I decided, I think that I will keep them in the guitar. I see no reason really to change them. And also, I mean, the tuners, the only reason for me to change the tuners would be to change them to locking tuners instead. But yeah, we will see. Maybe I will do that later on. But I mean, tuning stability is perfect with this guitar. So. And I mean, look at it, it's really the headstock, matching headstock, and Rob Chapman's nice signature, and fretboard is really smooth and beautiful, and the Infinity inlay is very nice. I mean, it's really, for the price, in Sweden this guitar cost about 450 euros, so in dollars, US dollars, it would be like $500 or something. And in that price range, okay, there is a lot of competition. Myself, I was very close to buy a Squire Classic Vibe, the 60s version, and it's a really nice guitar too. And you can't go wrong with that guitar either. I mean, it's high quality and everything. But there is something about this guitar, and there is also something about this brand. It's a kind of underdog. And I mean, if you look at Rob Chapman's videos and Anderson's videos and everything, there is it's something special with these guitars, for sure, in my opinion. A little bit different. You can really feel when you play the guitar that they really took some time and effort to do the best they can in this price range. I mean, it's so there is really nothing bad to say about this brand or guitar. So, and this the modern series is made in Indonesia, and I think their pro series is made in Korea at the famous World Music Factory. Actually, I believe the same owners of the World Music Factory is also the same at this Indonesian factory. So, and it's really, really nicely done. So, the weight of the guitar is actually, I owned my first real guitar was also a Chapman guitar. It was the earlier version of the ML1. It was a humbucker single configuration, and it was a natural mahogany body. And yeah, I just started to play guitar more seriously when I bought this Chapman guitar used, and but I didn't connect so much with that guitar. I don't know if I would do it today, maybe it would be different, but One thing I noticed with that guitar was that it was very heavy. And I know that they got some complaints later on about the weight of the guitars. And this guitar is much lighter. So that's also nice if you playing gigs or something, and you need to care about your shoulders a little bit too. So
yeah, so thank you for watching, and this was maybe a little bit different, not a normal review, but it's yeah, more about the fit and finish and electronics and what I think about the guitar. But it's really, really a nice guitar, and I have several guitars, but this guitar has what you call the mojo. When you sit down with this guitar, you feel inspired, you feel like you really want to play. And I have all my guitars hanging on the wall, and every time I see it, I just get this feeling that I want to play guitar. And that's really what you're looking for when you're choosing a guitar. You want to feel inspired and so on. So I highly recommend it. So okay, thank you for watching, and have a nice day. Bye bye.